If you've heard about zero waste, then you would have heard about bamboo toothbrushes. Bamboo brushes are growing in popularity as a sustainable alternative to the plastic ones. But like I always mention in my videos, there is no one perfectly sustainable product. Everything that we use and everything that we do has an impact on the environment. And overdependence on any particular thing always leads to a negative impact. This made me wonder about all the sustainable products that are available to us in the market today. How sustainable are they, and is it possible that we may end up misusing them in the future that will make them unsustainable for use? So I started searching about this on the internet and I thought I'd share my thoughts and findings with you all. I'm starting with the impact of bamboo brushes in this video, but I will be making more like this in the future. So if you haven't subscribed yet, make sure you do it and also turn on all notifications so you don't miss any of them. Now getting into today's topic, the impact of using bamboo toothbrushes on the environment. Let's first start with the positives. The brush handle is obviously made from bamboo, which is generally considered to be a very sustainable material. The bamboo plant grows really fast and it usually doesn't require any fertilizers or pesticides to grow. Then once it is harvested to be made into brushes or any other products, the plant can regrow itself through the rhizomes under the soil. This means we don't have to spend a lot of time to replant the bamboo once it is cut. Growing of bamboo also improves the quality of the soil and prevents soil erosion. So it can actually be used for land restoration. It can be planted in used farmlands that have degraded in quality, and the bamboo can really help replenish the soil. Since the toothbrush handle is made from this natural material, it is completely biodegradable. It can be composted at composting facilities or even in a home compost. And though it may take more time, it can even be buried or thrown in the garden and it will eventually biodegrade. Bamboo is also very durable, which means after it's used for brushing teeth, it can be reused for many other purposes. It can be used to clean electronics or other small and tough to reach spaces, or it can also be creatively used in craft projects and so on. So to summarize the positive impacts, bamboo cultivation is not resource intensive and it benefits the soil. And after use, the toothbrush can be reused several times or can be composted back to the soil, thus reducing a lot of waste. However, in most cases, you will have to remove the bristles before composting. We'll see why in a minute. Now let's move on to the negative impacts caused by this product. The main problem with the bamboo toothbrush lies in the bristles. There are a few different materials used by different manufacturers to make them. The most popular material is petroleum-based nylon. Most manufacturers use nylon 6, which is non-biodegradable, but sometimes the bristles could be made of nylon 4. Nylon 4 can break down under specific laboratory conditions, but this does not mean that it can biodegrade in nature or in a compost, and I could not find any evidence for this. So it's always preferred to pull out the bristles with a pair of pliers before composting the handle. Another option to deal with the bristles is recycling, but it's done very rarely and most recyclers do not accept it. Another material used for the bristles is pig hair. This is biodegradable, but it is animal based. This means it is not vegan or cruelty free, which comes with its own implications on the environment. Also, whether this material is hygienic to be used in a toothbrush or not is also questionable. Some articles on the internet also mentioned a few plant-based and biodegradable materials used for the bristles, but they were either of poor quality or they were being mixed with materials like nylon. Keeping the problem of bristles aside, let's look at some other ways in which bamboo brushes can have a negative impact. As bamboo starts to become more popular, the demand for bamboo cultivation will also go up. This could lead to clearing of natural forests to make space for bamboo cultivation. Deforestation is obviously a bad thing and can lead to habitat loss and endangerment of several species. This can also affect the ecological balance and contribute to climate change. This all may seem like looking too much into the future, but we've seen it happening with materials like paper and palm oil, and we have to make sure we don't repeat the same mistakes with bamboo. Though bamboo does not require fertilizers or pesticides to grow, there is no guarantee that they are not being used to increase productivity. Another factor to consider is, if bamboo is not grown locally where you live, a lot of energy will have to be used for transportation from the forest to the manufacturers and finally to your home. There is no denying that the introduction of bamboo as a sustainable material has paved a way to reduce plastic pollution in the world. Bamboo is being used for many products: toothbrushes, cutlery, straws, instruments, flooring, it's even used in clothing. But if we over-depend on this material for everything around us, it may soon become unsustainable for use, and we don't want that to happen. I hope this video was informative to you. There is no wonder material that will solve all our problems. It's important to be aware of what we use so that we can try our best to use them with the least negative impact. If you enjoyed this video and would like to see more like this on this channel, do let me know in the comments and give this video a thumbs up. Also, share this video, and if you're new here, consider subscribing. Thank you for watching.